You know, when I look around at all the entrepreneurs who are grinding it out, spending 70 to 80 hours per week growing their business, you have to ask yourself the question, at what cost? Hi, my name's Tim Uchuk, and in this podcast, we're going to be exploring the tools, tactics, and strategies for crushing it and scaling your business without making the ultimate sacrifice of your time and freedom. Hey, what's up, everyone? Hope you are at this moment in time able to keep your head above water. At the time of this recording, that pandemic, or at least the start of it, is upon us. And I'm just kind of watching a lot of the stuff that's going on in the news. There's a lot of fear, a lot of unknown. I'm just watching and wondering what the impacts are going to be by industry, by business, by geography. It's interesting and a little bit scary, a lot of that unknown stuff. And part of this podcast episode is really to address what's going on right now in the wake of how people are responding to this pandemic. And I know within my business, we're encouraging our employees, if they're feeling sick, to stay home and isolate themselves. And I think this is going to be, I just saw an announcement that in the NBA, it sounds like they're postponing the remainder of the season. Sounds like it might be happening in the NHL as well, pretty quickly. So pretty interesting. In the midst of this, it's made me think of, I don't know if in this podcast I've really shared, how I went about learning a lot of, what I teach, which is all around how to make, coming into the office optional. And so this means, you know, what would your business need to look like? How would your teams and your operations need to be structured in order for you to be able to run it from anywhere? And what would that need to look like? And so why did I ask this question? Well, for me, and again, I don't know if I've shared this. This is a bit of an origin story. I remember at the time, this is going back nearly a decade, my office being a revolving door for like all day long. Questions, problems, challenges, you name it, my office door, I would put my head down. And I'm terrible at context shifting. I've got like one channel in my brain. My wife knows this. And when I'm focusing on something and I get thrown off, it's hard to get back into the zone. So it was like not a good place in terms of me being able to get stuff done, because I don't know if you can relate, just people coming in constantly. And so I fantasized about a day and a world where I didn't have an office. I thought the easiest way to eliminate people coming into my office was to not have an office at all. And so I became obsessed with digitizing everything. I remember my team thinking I was insane because I was accelerating everything getting into the cloud. So managing our teams, managing our projects, managing my files. Everything was in the cloud so that I could just have my computer with me, just have my laptop, and regardless of where I was, I could function effectively. And so eventually, I'm just going to the Bottle Depot. Those are cans in the back of my car. Eventually, I ended up getting rid of most of the stuff in my office, became quite sparse. I got a stand-up desk. And I placed it in our boardroom. So I spent like a couple years working out of the boardroom in a stand-up desk with like nothing. And it forced me, it was like one of those constraints, it forced me to get a system together and in place so that this reality would become possible. So that's a bit of an origin story where a lot of what I teach comes from. And then fast forward, of course, to the last year and a bit. And I made the ultimate move to running my business and my team. We've got just over 50 people remotely. And that's kind of the origin story. So in that, I wanted to share some tips. If you are being impacted by what's going on right now and you're having to manage your teams remotely, I just want to offer a couple tips to help you do that effectively. And so in our training, we use something called Trello. And again, the tool is really secondary, but I like to keep things really simple. Trello is like digital post-it notes. And essentially, and this goes back to my lean manufacturing days, but what you want to do when you're working remotely is because in the absence of not being able to see your team, you need to make the work visible. So the work needs to be visible in terms of who's doing what. And this is where we use Trello. So when tasks are assigned, it's clear on who owns what. So one set of eyeballs, and when is it due? And is it clear on what specifically needs to be done? And then next, the second part, so that's making work visible. The second part is working in 1 week sprints. So rather than giving people massive deadlines, 2 months, 3 months out, we break work down into 1 week, which eliminates procrastination, forces us to prioritize. And so when we meet, typically on Mondays or Tuesdays, and we're assigning out work, we focus on what can get done in the next week. And so that shortens the cycle, and it gets people to focus on the here and now, and it loads people's today and this week up. Rather than, if it was stretched out to the next month or 2 months, then a lot of people, just like in university, they can put it off and procrastinate and wait until, the last week, the 11th hour. So making work visible, that's number one. We use Trello for that. And number two, working in 1 week sprints. Number three, this is another big one, is your measurables. So again, you've probably heard me say this a million times, but what gets measured improves. And number two, what gets measured and reported improves exponentially. So you want to look within each department of your business, depending on the makeup. And you would ideally, just like a doctor, you would have the ability to look at each department week over week and understand what does healthy look like and how can we measure it. And so if you're working on projects, what does healthy look like and how can you measure it? And so that would be, on time, on track, or measuring things that are, off track or overdue. Sales, you would just measure your weekly sales, weekly quotes, weekly, number of meetings. If you've got technicians, you're measuring things like efficiency, you're measuring things like callbacks or internal warranty. Finance, you're measuring things like your cash flow, your receivables outside of 90. And so this is really, these three things are the key to how I run my teams remotely. And for those measurables, it's really simple. It's like a golf scorecard where we just look at a simple table with all these numbers week over week. It's all conditionally formatted, green, yellow, red. So we look at it every Monday. We've got a very specific agenda. And we look at the work, who's doing what, did it get done? And we look at our measurables, green, yellow, red. What's in the red? We diagnose, we troubleshoot, we get down to the root cause, and we solve it. And it's as simple as that. And so those are kind of the three things that I've learned over the last decade, running my teams remotely, that eliminates a lot of that feeling of being in the dark. Worrying that your team's not getting anything accomplished. If you have these three things in place, you'll be able to navigate this world much more confidently. So I hope that's helpful. I don't know for any of you that are transitioning, maybe you already have a remote team and you're just looking to make things more effective, or maybe during this crisis, your work habits are having to shift and you're having to run things remotely. So I hope that's helpful. By the way, in our, I think it's bookwithtim.com, if you go there, I actually share the Trello board that I use, and it's very similar to the one that we teach with our team management. So feel free to go there, and you'll automatically get emailed this Trello board, which could be helpful if you don't have anything. I mean, we've tried all of the different software tools over the years, and to be honest, most of them out there, in my opinion, they have too many features and bells and whistles, and human beings are prone to make things complicated. And what I found is the team to working with, or the team, the trick to working with big teams, is to keep things simple, right? Because the more complexity means more learning curves, and more room for people to use things differently and misinterpret how to use the system, and it's easy to lose track of all the moving parts. So there's a real benefit to keeping things simple, and that's why we use Trello and a set of simple patterns and principles to just keep the main thing the main thing, and spend more time executing than actually managing, if that makes sense. So Anyways, I hope you're all well and healthy in the midst of what's going on. I wanted to share just some quick tips if you are transitioning to having to work remotely. I'm going to drop off my cans here at the depot. My wife had asked me to do her a favor. So, hope that's helpful. I will catch you guys in the next episode and enjoy the rest of your day. Hey, Tim Uchuk here. And real quick, if you enjoyed this podcast episode, if you could take a couple quick seconds to give it a rating, it would be very much appreciated. And secondly, if you're looking for more tools and strategies on how you can crush it in life and business, just head on over to bookwithtim.com, where I've put together a free case study which shows you how to unlock unprecedented freedom today by using the two power levers. Just head on over to bookwithtim.com. Until next time, wishing you success and freedom in your business. Cheers.